I'm Rebecca Romaine Stamos, and I'd like to welcome you to a little experiment we're calling Space Fighters. Here's the deal. We've decided that if it's okay for Puffy to rip off beats from Sting and Gloria Estefan, of all people, then we've got no problem in enabling you to bite the look of your favorite star. As the video age cliche goes, imitation is the sincerest form of flattery. So we've rounded up a pack of fans eager to worship their idols by biting their looks. We're going to send these kids through a battery of stations where they'll get a chance to direct some of the fashion world's top-notch hairstylists, makeup artists, and dressers. These are the folks that help the stars themselves create their looks. Now, before we dig in, let me introduce you to a few special guests that'll decide which of these fans will be rewarded as a day's best replicant. This is a contest, after all, isn't it, Maya?
Well, you better believe today is a contest. And in round one, we're going to rate each of these kids on how best they can resemble their idol.
All right. Well, thank you, Maya. So in round one, it's strictly looks that count because we're shallow like that. Also giving us a hand will be Jordan Knight. Now, you may remember Jordan from his days with the New Kids on the Block, but now he's back with a brand new album, and he's here to tell us about the second round of scoring that we're going to be putting these kids through. Jordan?
This is the deal. The first round is worth 30 points, but in the second round, they'll get one more chance to impress us, and it's worth 15 points, and that is the overall believability round.
All right, you got it, Jordan. In the overall believability round, the kids can really get loose and use their creativity to convince us that they have truly channeled their hero of choice. I expect to see some hardcore singing and dancing in this round, baby. All right, we've got one more judge. Ladies and gentlemen, Cher.
Thanks. Actually, I'm not Cher. I'm just an impersonator. But I am a licensed cosmetologist, and I'll be doing each of our contestants' nails.
All right, thank you, Cher. You had us fooled. Now, everyone likes getting their nails done, but that is not our grand prize. No, 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 no. Our overall winner will immediately be whisked away in a limo that we have stocked, full of groupies, bodyguards, and paparazzi, so that they can continue the fantasy that we're going to help them create right here, well into the night. Now, right now, let's dive into this thing before we send each of our contestants through our makeover ringer. We're going to briefly get acquainted and allow them to prove their super fandom to us. Please welcome Sheena Michelle, the world's biggest Britney Spears fan. Welcome, Sheena.
Hi,
how are you?
Good.
Sit down. Are you excited?
Yes, I am.
Around, give it a little spin, just like in her video. You got the sexy little Catholic schoolgirl thing happening. You feel good?
Yes.
Good. All right, let's check it out with the judges and see what's happening over here. Maya, what do you think?
Well, she could have fooled me, and it is still the beginning of the show.
You think you would have been fooled?
Yeah.
Really?
She looks just like Britney Spears. So I gave her a 9.
A 9, not bad at all. All right, now, Maya, if you were in our contest, who would we be transforming you into today?
You would have to probably transform me into Tina Turner.
You're a big fan of Tina Turner?
Yeah.
All right. Is she your inspiration?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Now, you've got a new single and a video out. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, my new single is called My First Night With You.
My first night with you.
Jordan?
I went with Maya's score, a 9.
A 9?
I think she looks very much like Britney
Spears. Not bad. Very, very respectable.
She's got the moves, she's got the looks, she's got the pom-poms and everything.
It's
so
perfect, I know. It's great. All right, Cher?
I just love this look. I think she looks very sexy, but also very innocent. From a distance, you're her. I love it. I give her a 10.
Great. With a very impressive score of 28, Sheena Michelle draws a line in the sand with her first round tally. We'll check in with Sheena again in our overall believability round, but right now we've got James King in our Madonna-rama room.
Hey, what's up? We've moved a little deeper into Madonna's...
Do you like being a blonde?
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, let's see what the judges think. Maya?
Okay. At first I had a 6. But he just lifted up his shirt and I shaved it to a 7.
See? See? All right, you swayed your vote. Jordan, what did you give him?
I think the contrast in his hair is a little too different than what Justin's is, so
you gave him a 6. All right. Now, you kind of paved the way for bands like NSYNC. What do you think of those guys?
I think NSYNC, the Backstreet Boys, all the guy bands out today, it's cool to see, you know, because, yeah, we did pave the way, and we had people that we looked up to also, and, you know, it's a a flattering thing, and they're all very talented guys, so I feel they deserve.
I'm sure they took inspiration from you also.
A little bit.
So you should be flattered. Now, how does your new stuff compare with your old stuff?
It's more rhythmic, it's more mature.
Cher, what's your score?
I'm kind of undecided about the hair. Maybe it's a little different. The look is good. I think he's a heartbreaker. I'm going to give him a 7.
Not bad. That's a great score, Jimmy. Now we're gonna check in right now with James King, who has Sarah, our Mariah wannabe, trapped in our makeup station.
That's right, Rebecca. Makeup artist Monica Blunder is gonna show
to Mariah Carey. All right. Wow. Don't bend over. That's great. Judges, what do you think, Maya?
Okay. Definitely the hair.
Yep.
That's Mariah. I gave her a 7.
All right. Yeah. Not bad. Jordan?
I think the dress is very Mariah, the right cut. The hair. I think in her own right, she's a beautiful lady. And but I don't think she looks like Mariah. So I gave her a 6.
Okay. That was honest. Cher?
I think this look is very hot, very sexy. I can see, you know, where she was going. The hair looks great. Mariah is very difficult to do, but I think you pulled it off well. I'm going to give you an 8 for effort.
All right. Not bad at all. Not bad at all. You scored a 21, Sarah, and that's great. We'll be bringing you back during our overall believability round later in the show so that you can impress the judges one final time and hopefully get a chance to party like the rock star you think you are in this limo. In the meantime, James King would like to introduce our next contestant to you.
Lone's Monica makeover is going to be a little crazy.
Henry Keim. What do you think?
I liked his little entrance there.
That was good, huh?
Yeah. I know he showed up today with blonde hair, cut, and he went through a lot of trouble, probably. The extensions and the dyeing and the twist, and he looks very corn. So much props to you, man, and I give you a...
All right! Our first 10 of the day, I do believe. Jordan?
Yeah. I think he looks pretty good. I'll give him a 10.
All right! That's awesome. Cher?
I'm going to have to agree with Maya on this one. This was a major makeover, and he absolutely does look like corn. I'm going to give him a 9.
All right! The judges, Henry. You scored a 29, and now we've got a special surprise. We're going to spice this show up even more by putting our makeover pros to the test by tossing them a wild card. James King is out on the street attempting to pick up an extra mystery contestant.
What are you going to do?
Beautiful. How do you feel?
Ooh, I feel really good. At first I was kind of doubtful, but the stylist and everyone helped me kind of achieve the look. I really appreciate it.
You look gorgeous and sophisticated. Do you feel that way?
Definitely.
Oh, good. Judges, what do you think? Maya?
She looks like she's going to the Grammys to me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everything from the hair to the dress to the shoes and the armband is Monica. Just
All
like
right.
Monica's video.
All right. What's the score?
I gave her... An 8.
All right, not bad at all. Jordan?
I think she looks very elegant, as Monica does. The hair looks just like Monica's, and I gave her a 7.
Okay, not bad. Cher?
I love the dress. The extensions are great. You look very, very glamorous. You look like Monica. I give you a 9.
All right. Are you happy with that? All right. Simone Israel as Monica with a score of 24. She's right there along with Sheena as Britney Spears, who received a 28, and Jimmy as Justin. He got a 20. Our blood pressure's rising because up next, we're going to unveil our tribute to Madonna and then... I'll take a look. All right. Now, judges, I know we're not scoring her on this, but what do you think, Maya?
Oh, I say it is very basic, like Fiona, but edgy at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a petite version, and I think it works. And much props to you for wearing those 4-inch heels.
Yeah, really. And Jordan, what do you think? James King is committing some heavy worship at our Shrine to judges into believing that their makeover is so fierce they have almost become the star we have helped them to resemble. This round is worth 5 points per judge, and at stake is an all-out MTV financed large live-in night out on the town, complete with groupies, paparazzi, bodyguards, and other miscellaneous debauchery. A literal dream come true. We can't keep the groupies waiting any longer. Here's a quick rundown of the scores so far. Let's get this joint rocking. Here's Sheena as Britney Spears with Baby One More Time.
Oh, baby, baby. Oh, baby, baby. Oh, baby, baby. How was I supposed to know that something wasn't right here? Oh, baby, baby. I shouldn't have let you go. And now you're right in fire. Show me how you want it to be. Tell me, baby, 'cause I need to know now. Because my loneliness is killing me. And I must confess, I still believe.
Oh my God.
That was cute at the end. She cracked herself up. Definitely the outfit is Britney Spears.
Oh,
she had it choreographed and everything. I gave you a 4.
All right.
I thought it was very, very cute, and you messed up a little at the end, but that's cool because everybody messes up, and you did well with it, so I give you a 5.
All right. You're still in. Cher?
I think she looked very, very cute. She had the moves down. The end was a little messed up, but you kept going and you had a lot of energy. I give you a 4.
All right. Okay, now let's check out Jimmy as Justin performing I Want You Back.
It's hard to make the things I didn't know a lesson I've heard too well for sure. So don't hang up the phone now. I'm trying to figure out just what to do. I'm going crazy without you.
Maya, what'd you give him?
I have to give you a 5. Much personality.
All right. Jordan?
You sang really good. You were dancing a lot, and that means a lot. So I gave you a 4.
All right. Cher?
I gave you a 5.
Not bad. All right, now it's time to check out Simone as Monica performing Angel of Mine.
Ooh, yeah, 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 yeah.
The gestures were very Monica. I saw the eyes down and the hands. It came very close, and I gave her a 4.
All right. Jordan?
I like the little twirl and stuff she did with a voice like Monica does.
Mm-hmm.
And just based on that alone and her presence, I gave her a 4.
Great.
I loved her moves. She had the hand motions down. The look is great. The outfit is great. I give her a 4.
Great. All right, with a score of 41, Sheena has raced into the lead, but this one's far from over, my friends. Stay tuned because we've got performances from our Mariah and Jonathan Davis wannabes. And when we come back, you'll find out which of these Transformers is going to party all night long in this limo stocked with groupies, bodyguards, and butt kissers. We'll be right back. Contestants have 1 minute to creatively influence the judges into believing that they are, in fact, the star they think they are. With a score of 41, Sheena's in the lead, followed by Simone and Jimmy, and we've got 2 contestants to go. Judges, are you ready?
Yes. Yeah.
Ready. All right. You've already checked out his awesome makeover, and now he's ready to rock out. Here's Henry Keim as Jonathan Davis with Freak on a Leash.
Feel like a freak on a leash. Feeling like I have no release. How many times have I felt disease? Nothing in my life is free, is free. Sometimes I cannot take this place. Sometimes it's my life I can't taste. Sometimes I cannot feel my face. You'll never see me far from grace. Something takes a part of me. You and I were meant to be. A cheap for me to lay. Something takes a part of me.
Performances today. Judges, what did you think of Henry?
I think he could have been just a tad bit more dramatic. So I still gave him a 4, though.
Not bad. Jordan?
I give you a 5.
Great. All right. This is a 1 through 5 score, so that's pretty good. Cher?
I give him a 4.
All right. Now we've got Sarah as Mariah Carey performing I Still Believe.
I'm filled with all the joy I could find. You know that I'm not the desperate type. If there's one spark of hope left in my grasp, I'll hold it.
All right. Great. Jordan?
You did it very well. Thank you.
Great. And Cher?
I was very impressed with what I saw. It is very gutsy to come out here. You looked great. And I give you a 5.
All right. 3 perfect scores. That's great. Happy about that? All right. I'd like to bring back my co-host, James King, and all the rest of the contestants.
All right.
Let's have one more round of applause for these guys. I just want to say that it was a very close race, and our runner-up with a score of 41 is Sheena Michelle Ruiz. with a score of 42 is Jonathan Davies as portrayed by Henry Kyne. You heard that right, Jonathan Davies and Korn. There's two of you on this town tonight. Get the hell out of here. You got partying to do.
Which is older, that car or those moves? I don't know. The new kid on the block, though, has a new career. Former teen heartthrob Joey McIntyre scored 9 top 10 hits as one of the new kids on the block. Now at age 26, he's branching out on his own. Joey invited us to check out his new sound with a visit to his Massachusetts home. Now, you won't find any Hollywood glitz here, but you will find plenty of memories from his days as a new kid. In the late 80s and early 90s, they sold millions of CDs and became a household name overnight as the new kids on the block. Joey McIntyre was the baby of the bunch. This is him then, and take a look at him now. It's been years since he performed with the group, but he clearly remembers it was all about making music and having fun.
We hung out all the time, and we were in the studio together, we played basketball together. It just had a good feel to it.
Even all growing up, he's still got the girls screaming and has just launched his first solo album, Stay the Same. And I hope you always stay the same. We caught up with Joey at his new bachelor pad in Brookline, Massachusetts, where his collection of new kids and music memorabilia is so huge, it has its own room.
This room right here, it's mostly the museum, if you will, you know. Got everything from, I love Frank Sinatra, so I got some of his old albums, and, of course, the doll. I mean, how many people have had a doll made of them, you know what I mean? And Oprah, when we did Oprah, that was when I was Frank and Dean's caddy. No, sorry. That was just a picture by themselves, but I got one with Frank down here, actually. This is me, my father, and Frank. We started the American Music Awards. We won back in 1990 for best album and best group. And a lot of stuff like, the gold albums and stuff like that. It's cool. Very glitzy stuff. But I put it all in one room, so I can have a normal house. I don't want it all over the house.
And outside of that room, he's just a regular guy who likes to shoot pool with his buddies.
Who produced this one?
Who cares?
Or just hang out and listen to some good music. His, of course. And I hope you always... As you can see, Joey seems to have it all. Good friends, a new solo career, and has some words of advice for young musicians who are just starting out.
You know, the whole thing, like, watch out for what you wish for, because you might get it.
There's nothing about you I would change.
Sounding good. Meanwhile, back in Manhattan, we are talking about the...
is waiting on her. I know the SS spring break is waiting on her. And I know Cancun is waiting on Foxy Brown, right?
Cancun!
Yeah! So don't go away. She's coming up next.
You're laying low.
This water.
Oh, and as you can see...
I'm Joey tonight. What's up? We're here in Cancun at Fat Tuesdays, and it's all that, man. It's everything it looks like.
And this is the grind all over.
Yeah, and all over means all over the tropics. Jamaica, SS Spring Break, and here in Cancun.
That's right.
Now, up and coming, we're going to have Foxy Brown doing a little something, as we said earlier. She's going to rip it up.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you've heard her on the radio. You've seen her on TV. DJ Coco Chanel, what you got, baby?
Y'all, my name is DJ Coco Chanel. Before I get started, I want to know, where are my
The original was dope, but the remix, off of her. Tyrese, Funkified.
Tell them what's going on, man.
I just want to know, I want to get a reaction from that last cut. Jamaica, how'd you like that last cut by Tyrese?
Yeah.
The cruise ship, I felt the cruise ship making waves all the way over here in Cancun, man.
Cancun's a bomb, man.
But what's up right about here?
Yeah, go for Chanel, man. She's getting busy.
That's right. Pumping the crowd up. Right now we're gonna go to Ghetto Superstar.
Check it out.
Foxy is like teasing the pants off of us.
Yeah, man. She's coming soon, man.
She's like backstage.
Foxy's coming soon.
She will be here.
Plus, we got tons more music, and it's on from Cancun. Stay tuned, baby.
Welcome back to the grind all over MTV's Global Dance Party. My name is Jordan Knight.
And I'm Joe McIntyre.
And let me tell you something. We got it going on in Jamaica. We got it going on in the SS Spring Break. And we got it going on in Cancun. Yeah, baby. We got all the jams pumping all day long.
Yes, and what? Foxy Brown, dog.
Foxy Brown's gonna be here, getting busy, getting
stage.
Down, and I can't wait to see it. She got a new album,
China Dog.
Yeah, dog. Right now, we're gonna go to a song by Britney Spears. Here we go now. Coco Chanel ripping the turntables.
She not only sounds good, she looks good.
Oh yeah.